Hi, this is Paula from Go Laser Go, and in this video I'm going to go through the Cuts and Layers panel here to show you a little bit how the ordering of layers work and also attempt to answer a viewer's question. So on the screen at the moment I've got this little circle here with the letter A in it, and I want the outline to cut and the inside here, the letter A, to engrave. So you can see at the moment that it's all sitting on one layer. So if I want this to cut and this to engrave, I have to separate the layers out. So to do that, I'm going to click on the A and I'm going to change the color down here, just give it another color. You can see as soon as I do that, we get now two layers here. So the first one is the line, so that's what I want. I want that to cut. And this one I want to fill, I want to engrave. So that's what it looks like there. And just to help visually show this, I'm just going to come up to the settings up here. And I'm going to click on Filled Rendering and go OK. And that will show now the engraving. Now you also see that the outline is at the top here and the engraving is the second one down. Now normally when you are engraving something and cutting, in general you usually want to engrave first. And the reason you want to do that is if you cut this first, you'll notice when you cut something, it often will fall through the wood and it might turn sideways, that sort of thing. And then when you come back to engrave it, it's going to be out of alignment. So you really want to engrave first and then cut. Now, this is the ordering of it now, and you'll see what is going to happen if I click on preview up here. You can see it's going to cut first the outline and then engrave. So we don't want that. We want it in the other order. So if I come back here and just click on the bottom one here, and just click this arrow, you can see now the fill or the engraving is at the top and then the cutting is underneath. So we come back to preview, click on it, and you can see that in action now. So it's going to engrave the letter first and then cut it. There we go. So that's great. So what if we had more than one of these? So what I'm going to do is I'm going to group this, right click and group. So it's nicely grouped, and I'm going to add a few more. So I'm coming down to the array tool down here, and I'm going to just click another three and another three down and go OK. So I've got more than one here. Now if we come back up to the preview, we'll see how this is going to play out. So I'll come back. Now you'll notice it's engraving all the A's first, and then it's going to come round and do the outlines, which is great. That's normally what I would do. But we had a viewer request and they wanted it done in a different way. They wanted the letter A to be done first on this first one, and then they wanted it to be cut around the outline there, and then the second A and cut around here and so on. So they wanted each one done individually. Okay, so let's see how we can do that. So if I click OK to get out of there, I'm going to come down to these options here. Now make sure you've got Optimize Cut Path selected. But I'm going to click on Optimization Settings, and you'll notice here it's got the ordering priority. So that tells you how these are going to be cut and engraved. Now I'm going to just remove both of them. Okay, remove, and I'm going to select instead Order by Group and go OK. Now remember this, it's ordering by group. So if you're going to make this work, you have to make sure that each one of these are grouped. Remember I've grouped them. I grouped the A and the outline together. So all of these are grouped. So you want to make sure each individual one is a grouping. So once that's done, if we come back up to preview, click on that and come back and let's see this in action. Okay, there you go. So it's doing each individual A and then coming round and doing the outline. So there you go. So hopefully that answered your question. Thank you for the question to that viewer. And thank you for watching, everyone else. And please subscribe to the channel. And please give us a thumbs up. It really does help the channel.